Now we are going to discuss about the middle ear. This middle ear is otherwise known as the tympanic cavity or the tympanum. Okay. Now we are going to see the shape. Shape, it is a side-to-side compressed cube-shaped cavity. See, it's a cube-shaped cavity. What is related to that cube? It is compressed from sides. Okay. So it's a side-to-side compressed cube-shaped cavity. See, I already told you it is a cube-shaped cavity, so it is having 6 walls. What are the anterior, posterior, superior, inferior, medial, and lap. Now we are going to see the features of these walls. Okay, first we are going to see the features of these walls. See, this is what the middle ear. Okay, see, I already told you this one is external ear, then middle ear, then inner ear. See, roof, floor, medial wall, lateral wall, then here we can see the posterior wall also. And anti-one wall, anterior wall. So this side-to-side compressed cube-shaped cavity, this is the middle ear. Okay, first we are going to discuss about the walls. Hoof. Hoof is otherwise known as a tegmental wall. Okay, hoof is formed by a thin plate of bone or the tegmental tympani. It separates the middle ear from the middle cranial fossa. See here, this is the middle ear. See, this thin plate which forms the roof of this middle ear. This thin plate is known as tegmental tympani. This thin plate which separates this middle ear from this middle cranial cavity. This is the middle cranial cavity. There we are having the temporal lobe of the brain. Okay, so this middle cranial cavity is separated from the middle ear by this tegmental tympani. Okay, so roof. Then floor is formed by another thin plate which separates the superior bulb of the internal jugular vein from this middle ear. See here, this is the thin plate. So here we can see the internal jugular vein, a part of the internal jugular vein, this one is superior bulb, a bulging is seen in the superior, internal jugular vein, this one is the superior bulb of the internal jugular vein. Okay, so in floor is formed by another thin plate. So that's why it's known as jugular wall. It is related to the internal jugular vein. So roof and floor. Now anterior wall is having some features. Okay, anterior wall, there we are having two openings. The first opening for the tensor tympani muscle. See here, this is the anterior wall. Suction through the anterior wall. So here we can see the anterior wall, then suction through the posterior wall, then the lateral wall. Okay, so this is the anterior wall, this area, this is the anterior wall. So here we are having one opening, one muscle is there. This muscle is known as a tensor tympani. So one opening for the tensor tympani, then below that another opening, this is the opening of the auditory tube. Okay, so two openings are there in the anterior wall. One is the canal for tensor tympani. The another opening is the opening of the auditory tube. These two openings are separated by a thin plate. See, this is the canal for tensor tympani. Here, this is the auditory canal. These two canals are there in the anterior wall. Okay, these two canals are separated by a thin plate. See this thin plate. This thin plate runs backward as a thin process. This one is what processes of clariformes. Okay, so it is nothing but the continuation, backward continuation of this thin wall separating this canal for tensor tympani and the auditory canal. These two canals are separated by a thin plate. Its posterior continuation is known as what processes of clariformes. So these are the features of this anterior wall. Now, posterior wall. Posterior wall is also having an opening. It is known as the adductus. What is that? See here, this is the middle ear. Okay, posterior part there we are having an opening. See this canal. This is the adductus. What is the importance of this adductus? This adductus connects this middle ear to this airspace, one of the mastoid antrum. This is the mastoid process. So inside the mastoid process, numerous air spaces are there. Okay, the largest air space seen inside the mastoid process is one of the mastoid antrum. So this mastoid antrum is connected to this middle ear through this canal or through this opening, which is the adductus. So posterior wall is having one opening, which is the adductus. In addition to that, there we are having fossa inguinis for the short process of the incus. See this image. See here, this is the upper part of the posterior wall. See here, we are having a fossa for the short process of the Indus. That is what the fossa embodies. Okay. So, aditus is clear, then fossa embodies is also clear. Then one more projection is there, that is what the pyramid. Inside the pyramid, there one canal is seen. That canal contains one muscle, which is the stapedius muscle. So these are the some of the major features of this posterior wall. An opening is there, it is known as the aditus. Through the aditus, this medial area is connected to the mastoideandrum. Then fossa embodies, it's a depression for the short process of incus. Then projection is there, that projection is known as pyramid. Inside the pyramid, one canal is there, that canal contains one muscle, it's known as the stapedius muscle. So imagine this is a posterior wall. In the upper part, we are having this opening, aditus here. A small projection pyramid. Inside the pyramid, one muscle is there, that was a stapedius muscle. It is the smallest muscle of the body. Then lateral wall. Lateral wall is formed by our tympanic membrane. We have to check it. See, this is a medial wall and this one is a lateral wall of this middle ear. Middle ear, its lateral wall means that this is a lateral wall formed by this tympanic membrane. The medial wall is having some features. First, projection. One projection is seen, it is as promontory. See, this is the medial wall. Okay. So, this rounded elevation is known as the promontory. Okay. Then, above the promontory, here we are having an opening. It is known as the oval window or the fenestra vestibule. Okay, which is seen posterosuperior. Correct now. This is the promontory, this is the anterior part, this is the posterior part. So, posterior superior means here, posterior superior to the promontory, there we are having one opening, it is a fenestra vestibular or the oval window. Then, inferior to that, see here we are having another opening, round window. See, fenestra cochlea or the round window, which is seen posterior, posterior, inferior to this promontory. Then, another prominence, see, prominence of the facial canal, another projection. Prominence of the facial canal runs backward. See where, see here. This one is a prominence of the facial canal. So, prominence of the facial canal, oval window, promontory, round window. In addition to that, processes of cleariformes. This processes of cleariformes. I already told you what is that processes of cleariformes. It's a thin plate separating this canal for tensor tympani from the auditory canal. Backward continuation. So, processes of cleariformes, promontory, oval window, prominence of the facial canal, round window. These are the features seen at the medial wall. Okay, so these are the features of this walls: anterior wall, posterior wall, medial wall, lateral wall, then roof and floor. So, six walls are clear. Now, inside this middle ear, so walls are clear. Now we are going to see the contents of this middle ear. This middle ear is having erosectors, malleus, incus, and stapes. Malleus, incus, and stapes. So three bones are there. We have to discuss about the features of those three bones. Now these three bones are connected by two joints. Okay. Then here two muscles are also there. So we are going to see the details of those structures seen inside the middle ear. What are the structures seen inside the middle ear? So we have to discuss about the erosectors. Already told you three bones are there, malleus, incus, and stapes. See, first one, malleus. Malleus, it resembles the hammer. It looks like the hammer. So it is having one rounded head, neck, an anterior process, lateral process, and one hand. See, this is what our malleus. Here we can see one rounded head. Then this concept about this is what the neck. Then this one is the hand. Okay, so handle, then neck, then head. Those things are very clear. Now, this projection, this is a lateral process. And anterior process is not there in this image. It directs anteriorly. So, these are the parts of the malleus. So, malleus, it looks like a hammer. And these are the parts of the malleus. Now, the incus. It looks like the anvil of blacksmith. That's what it's known as the incus. Okay, it is having a body and a long process. What is the peculiarity? See, first we have to identify. This is the body and this is the long process. What is the peculiarity of this body, long process and one small one is there, that one is a short process. Okay, so this one is a body. This body is having a preset for this malleus. Okay, to form a joint mass, inguinomalleolar joint between the incus and the malleus. So inguinomalleolar joint. This joint is known as inguinomalleolar joint. So body is having a preset for the malleus to form inguinomalleolar joint. So then long process. Long process which articulate with the head of the steps. See, here comes the steps. Steps bone. So here one rounded part is there. That one is the head of the step. The head of the step articulate with this long process. So that's all about the incus. Now the steps. Steps is having a small head, then narrow neck, then two limbs, one anterior and one posterior limb, then one foot plate. See, here comes the head that is not here in this image. Then this part, this is the neck, then anterior and posterior, then this is a foot plate. So head and neck, anterior and posterior limbs, then foot plate. Now joints. These bones are connected by two joints. What are the two joints? Already told you, inguinomalleolar joint between the incus and malleus, then between the incus and steps, inguinostipedial joint. It's a bone and socket variety of synovial joint. The first one is the saddle variety of synovial joint. Now, what are the muscles seen inside this middle ear? See, tensor tympani muscle and stapedius muscle. Stapedius muscle is seen inside the pyramid. Pyramid which is seen in the posterior wall. And the tensor tympani, in the anterior wall, there we are having one opening through which is the middle ear. So, two muscles are there. Now, arterial supply is supplied by anterior tympanic artery and posterior tympanic artery. Venous drainage drains into superior petrosal, sinus and pterygoid venous plexus, lymphatic drainage, pre-aortic claudicular propharyngeal lymph nodes, now supplied by the tympanic plexus. The tympanic plexus, it is formed by the tympanic branch of the glossopharyngeal nerve, the sympathetic plexus around the internal carotid artery. So these are the some of the details of this middle ear. The remaining details you have to read from your